Hi guys, my name's Tom and I'm going to be teaching you how to do a heart transplant in under 5 minutes in the game called Surgeon Simulator 2013. Right, this is Fred. Fred needs a heart transplant and he needs it now. The tools we have are my favourite, the hammer, some scalpels, these dartboard kind of looking things, a radio, a clipboard and a saw, which is slightly off to the screen. Right, we're going to be giving him a heart transplant and the aim is to do it in as quick as you can. Using this little hand thing, which is really easy to control. And by easy, I mean it's fucking retarded. But here we go, we're going to just try get into his ribcage safely, not causing any internal bleeding. We're going to get rid of that bad heart and put it in with this shining piece of kit. Oh, look at it. Oh, let's just rub it. Yeah, look how good it is. Look. New hearts. Right, before starting, guys, I like to do the professional thing and check my guy's asleep by smothering my hand over his face. Right, yes, he is asleep. He is, in fact, asleep. So we're going to be using a hammer, which is just over here. Right, let's just get that stuff off. Right, I need to be focusing on the hammer here. I don't need to be distracted by new tools. Right, you grip it with easy controls. Easy. There we go, look how easy that was, guys. Okay, look at his intense grip on the hammer. Right, we need to break into the man's ribcage, and we've got to be very careful not to leave the ribcage in his body. If we leave it in his body, that could be quite bad. Right, we don't need the hammer anymore. Right, we need to get rid of some of these lungs. Well, some of these, I mean all of them. Right, leaving the spine and the ribcage in him is quite a bad thing to do, so we're just going to need to throw that off the table there. He won't need a ribcage when we're done. It is a medical fact that ribcages aren't actually needed. If you just want to leave a bit in him, you know, it'll grow back. It's like a tree. So as long as we leave that, like, that one bit there, we'll just put that up to the top, and it'll be like a... It'll just regrow, really. Yeah, this is quite new modern science, so don't be afraid if you know some stuff and don't know some stuff, you know. It's all about the learning experience. Right, we're going to need to sever his arteries now, and this is quite a fast process for me. Normally I'm in the 3-4 minutes by now, but we're making good time. This guy might be out. Right, oh, we need to be careful though. The internal bleeding isn't good. Right, in case you guys didn't know. Right, we just need to sever that one. Right, his heart is now stopped beating. Successfully. As you can see, his blood level is slowly dropping now. So we're going to need to quickly remove the heart as quick as possible. Right. As a medical professional, I like to throw my heart of my patient at his face. I think this just lets you know that you're doing a good job. And sometimes, if you're not good at sports, you can miss his face. But that's nothing to worry about. I mean, you're in medical profession, not sports, so it's all right. If you're not up for throwing it at his face, you know, just throw it off the table. But if you miss the table, then I don't know. Don't really know. Right. As you can see, beakers are flying everywhere with joy at our successful operation. We're just going to clean the table before we finish up. Right. We just clean up the table, you know. People have got to use it as well. There we go. Oh, God. Alright, we just need to put this heart in him now. And he is. Right, guys, I'd like to thank you all for joining me in this successful event. We're making good time. We've made 3 minutes and 20 seconds. He's got half his blood left, so we can just get that back up to him. We're trying not to give him AIDS. I'd like to thank everyone. Thanks for your support. Here we go. Oh, God, why didn't that fix him? Normally the game ends. This is new. Maybe if I rub it. Oh, I think we're not allowed spines in there. Oh god, I did not plan for this. This is out of the video planning. Right. Maybe if we throw that away. Oh, but now how is his spine gonna regrow? Oh god. Are we not? Oh, don't tell me we're not allowed. Oh god, I don't think we're allowed these in. Well, this isn't good, guys. Basically, I don't think he's allowed the dart things in his body. Right. As silly as it may sound. Oh God, guys, he's beginning to drop a bit now. This isn't looking too good now. Fred may be dead. I think in this kind of situation, we're going to need to use the heart to get it out. The heart can be used as a like sort of spooning device, if you will. It is known, and it has been stated clearly before, that we can just move it around his body a bit. Right. Right, if we just kind of rub, if we rub it, then I think we may still have a successful transplant. Maybe everything isn't severed as much as I thought it was. I know. Right, if we just... Oh, fuck! Right. You've got to keep a calm head. You've got to keep a calm head. Right. If we just jab everything a little bit. Right. Oh, God. Oh, no. This is going horrible now. Right. Oh, fuck. Oh, God. Right. This isn't how I planned it to be, guys. It wasn't meant to be like this. Oh, no, we need the heart. Right, we'll just drop the heart there a second. Hearts cannot get infections, so it's all right just to leave up on the side. Obviously, there's a risk that the body could get an infection with my dirty blood hands. But thankfully, we've got well-trained staff that constantly clean the areas. Wait, we just need to check he's still asleep. Right, no, that's fine, he's asleep. Not really sure how I'm meant to get these out. As you can see, the controls aren't as fluent as I promised. I'd like to reassure you guys this doesn't normally happen. I'm a medical professional. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. No, no, the heart! Oh, God. It's all right. Right, good as new, good as new. Right, guys, I'd just like to thank you for joining me on this fine medical experience. It did take a minute and 18 seconds longer than I first planned, but as you can see, my rating is A++. And I'd just like you to take that into consideration. He still has about half of his blood level left. And as you can see, looks fine to me. I'm sure he'll live. If that's not reassurance, I don't know what is. I'd like to thank you on this magical journey. Thank you.